Alright, what's up guys? Welcome back to Resident Evil. And this is stream number 7, and fingers crossed we can finish disc 1 today, right now. Because we're not that far off. So, and I might turn the mic off because I've got these two fucking monkeys here. Piss me off. My sister's kids are staying here, and they're a fucking nightmare getting them to sleep. I think that's it. But yeah, I'm really excited at playing this game. That's all I can think about is this game, like. So I'm getting so close. I think I'm so close to the end. Like we've come so far. Like all this part of the game, like from the moment you go into this dimension the second time, I've never seen this part of the game before, like. We're gonna put that in there. And the code is 4231. A series of fucking buttons. Right. 4231. Right, it looks like the power has been restored. Right, there's an elevator switch, press it.
Jill!
Barry? Thank God you're safe.
You too, Jill. A noise I heard brought me down here, but I didn't expect to find a place like this. Have any idea as to what might be at the bottom?
There's only one way to find out.
That sound. It could be a person. Jill, go check it out. We had enough surprises for one day. I'll stay here and secure our escape route in case something happens.
Okay.
Alright. So, remember when we went into the courtyard, into the cabin? Into the outside, and we went into that cabin and got the crank, and we got knocked out, and we had to run away from this monster sort of thing. That's who we're going to be bumping into again. Right. Let's just see what we've got. Right, we're not going to be killing anything right now. Right, so we want to get a box, and inside the box, we need to crush it to get a broken flamethrower. Is that the right way? I want to go to the left. I'm not sure if the monster can come in this room. But when I practiced it earlier, I didn't have any problems here. Push the fucking... Jesus. You just don't want to bump into that monster. When you see it, you just got to go the other way. Something there. I swear there's like a... Playing a bit of Tomb Raider right now. Garbage compactor. There's a switch. Yes. Alright, so inside that box is a flamethrower that is now, I guess, broken. Right, will you take the broken flamethrower? Yes. I don't know why Barry just runs off. We've got the broken flamethrower, right? Right, we want to get to that switch. We did it. Because it didn't happen with me, but I think if you take too long, I think that monster pulls the lever so those hooks go back in, and I'm not sure if you've got the flamethrower already in there, you're done. But if you don't get there in time, I think she pulls the switch and those little hooks go back in. Fire has died out, but it shows signs of use. I'm not sure there's anything in here because everything seems really cluttered. Like there's a huge collection of various kinds of dolls that are all faded. I think that's something there. But yeah, we're gonna get attacked by fucking snakes again. Dagger. And not forgetting the frickin' jewelry box. Let me take the jewelry box. Alright, so this is what we need. Right, you got the stone ring. A family picture and notes. You see that photo there, the little girl in the middle. I think that's the monster that was like that monster we just seen just now, and the one on the right is her mum, and the one on the left is the dad. And she was looking for her mum, and it all makes sense in a minute, like in a little bit. But there's something written on the back. November 10, 1967, progenitor virus administered. Jessica administered virus type A, plasmolysing of tissue during cell activation, virus fusion, negative, action disposed. Lisa administered virus type B, plasmolysing of tissue during cell activation, virus fusion, positive but delayed. So that that's the monster we've just seen, and his name Lisa. Body modification, observed constant result status, continued protective observation. George, action terminated November 30th, 1967. There's a journal left by someone. Right, November 14th, 1967. I feel dizzy after that shot they gave me. I don't see Mum. Where did they take her? She promised that we would escape to get together. Did she escape alone and leave me behind? November 15th, 1967. I found Mum. We ate together. I was very happy. but she was a fake. Not my real mum. She same face, but different inside. Have to find mum. Have to give face back to mother. I got mum's face back. Nobody can have my mum except me. I attach her face to me so she doesn't go away. Because mum's sad when I meet her without her face. So it's just like Texas Chainsaw Massacre, you know, when the guy cuts the fucking guy's face off and stitches it to his own face. Right, November 17th, 1907. So they missed a 6 off that one. From inside box, scent of mummy. Maybe true mother there. Stone box hard. It hurts. Still rope in the way. Can't see mother because 4 stones. I think that's everything. Right, so we've got a few spaces left. So they gave you blue herb just in case you got bitten by those freaking snakes. Couple of weathered old barrels containing what looks like water. See, look, we're back in this place again. This is where we saw that monster for the first time, so she must have come down this hole. Look at all these freaking herbs we've got. Not sure what else we want. Of course we want. Do you want that? No, we don't want that yet. I'm trying to think, is there any more hunters in the mix? So I think for now we just want that and that. Fuck you now. Cabin. Put the ink back. So I'm not sure if we find anything on the way. Chat. Oh, what's up, Purple Kid? And Razzmatazz and Quarter Porter. You're lurking. Oh, what's up, Raz? Alright, let's focus. They're gonna put, there's another zombie on the other side of this gate, which you're probably not gonna expect. It made me jump as well, but just fucking got that twat here. When I played this earlier, do you know what made me jump also was the sound. It was the sound of the waterfall, the water coming down, that trickling down the waterfall. Because they put that extra zombie there. When I got to that part, I was expecting something to be there, and there wasn't. Fucking. But I think the biggest jump scare is when you're getting chased by the first boulder. Because you know, you just know it's going to happen, you just don't know, I just wasn't sure when. What am I doing? So we want that. So yeah, if you're still in here, Quarter Porter, does your version of the game have two discs, or is it all on one on the Wii? Yes, it is. The two emblems fit neatly into the door. Open it. Yes, we've been waiting the whole game to open this freaking door. Right, so if anybody watching this, you know, hang on. Oh shit. You see that room there? Hang on, it's saying I've explored that room, but I haven't. You see the red door that says I haven't opened? It's saying I've been in there. I haven't been in there. out of fucking ink ribbon. I think I want that. Want that. I'm gonna save again just to be safe. I think that's it. Stairway parts. Is there anything here? It's so dark, you can't see shit. One disc. We're gonna give Barry his gun back, because when I played it earlier, he ends up dying, and I think he meant to keep him alive. Calm down, Lisa.
No time to talk. Jill, hand me my gun.
Right, we'll give it him. Push it then. That's the last one. Crazy bitch. Alright, so where's Barry then?
I don't believe that thing's really dead. Leave this place up to me. Go on ahead.
Okay.
Barry's face looks like he's got mental issues. Like he's like a, he looks like a psycho. So where are we now? A circular depression is an eagle shaped. Right, so that must be the eagle one. Circular depression, there's a wolf shaped emblem. There we go, that's the wolf one. But what's in this other door? There's like another door there. There's a large iron door and it won't budge. Press the open button and open the disc cover. Switch from game disc 1 to disc 2. Right, I better not lose my fucking signal for doing this. Right, give me a sec, guys. Switch the disc over. Right, from here, I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I don't know what I'm doing. Alright. This two time. So imagine that, I went to go and put disc two in, but they were both disc one. So when I bought the game ages ago, I got this about a few years ago. Imagine that, and they're both disc one. And I'm fucked. I'm supposed to look at the map. Right, so what do I need? What do I need? Help me out, Quarter Port. I don't know what I'm doing here. I'm gonna get the handgun out. Just in case. I'll put that back. So what do I need? Do I need that? We've still got this other item we haven't used yet, this floppy disk. And a wooden mount, what does that do? Alright, reflect that. In fact, right, this part isn't too long, but can you walk me through it then? Is there another part from here on? Is there another part where I can open and get things out? I think we'll stick with this for now. And if we fail it, oh, the mount is useless. What was it used for anyway? I didn't see anything like what it could have been used for. There's something here. Well, I would, but I've got to finish up work. Ah, what? You got to finish up work. Right then, if we don't finish, if I can't figure it out, I'll do it in the next stream. You're on your own for about half hour. Oh, what, so the rest of the game is about half hour. Alright, he's just pissed his pants. Alright, we've got 100 bullets. 100 bullets. From the handgun, which I probably won't even fucking use. But hang on, look at the map. So what's this? The Mo Disc. Hang on. They're both called Mo Disc. Am No disc, that says 1,200. I don't know which one's the right one now. Are they both the same? Well, I know that the top one is the one that I got first. It's locked electronically. Right, so I'm not going in there. Where is he? Why did you just unequip it, you cunt? Alright, fuck it. Shotgun time. Oh, he's there! I thought he was going to come from the other side. At least we know he's on the other side. He's going to come out from the left. So I'm a fucking sweaty bastard when it comes to these things. I always look for the easier way out. Let's look at the map layout, where we can go. So this looks like it's like a square. He ain't dead. Oof! Fucking headshot. What do you want to fucking call it? A noodle knocker. See the angle, I can't see shit. Right, turn left. So where do we want to go? Let's try this three rooms. The other two look like they're probably locked. Like, you can listen to myself like squirming. I don't know what to do. This is blind, by the way. Like, oh my god! Look at that. Look, you see this? Look at the size of that computer screen. What's happening there? Umbrella. I don't know if you've got to use that. Maybe I've got to use it for this computer. Password adder. Login John, password adder. I know that, but where did you get that clue? Where did you find that? Where am I looking? So if you weren't here, what would I be looking at to give that away? To think, oh, that's what it is. VX, researcher's note. There is now evidence that when the host loses consciousness, the body goes into a dormant state. During this time, the virus becomes active and rapidly transforms and reconstructs the basic composition of the body. The host eventually mutated into a humanoid creature. We call them VX. It's speed and amazing muscular development are particularly noteworthy. After transformation, it becomes more agile and aggressive. Already 4 of our researchers have died from trying to feed it, turning the place into an instant bloodbath. Ever since this tragic and barbaric accident, we have decided to call its kind Crimson Heads. That dangerous and precious prototype specimen can't be left there. We have to figure out a way to deal with it. Termination is definitely not an option. We finally decided to freeze the specimen and confine the body inside the basement of the backyard cemetery. Have I got to go back to the mansion? Or is that the monster that we dealt with at the start, like that when we got all the masks? So is it login John? Password adder. So where did you figure that out? Basement, third floor. So is this off the mansion? I don't know what the second password is. I wrote LCD when it is. Locked. A symbol resembling a power area is carved. Oh, what the fuck? I don't. Password is cell. Oh, you looked up in a walkthrough. He has. Try that again, John. Yes, shot. I don't know where these locations are. There must be more to this room than just that. There you go. I thought it might be, it looked like there were like shotgun shells on the shelf. Laboratory. So you can easily get lost in this area. Like, I've never seen it all before. What is that? Right, we're going to use that. The X-ray. The name on it is Clark David. An X-ray photograph. There's a name written at the top, Clark David. No. X-ray. That's Alex Betchett. Ed Fisher. He says his letter. June 8th, 1998. My dearest Ada, by the time you read this letter, I will no longer be the person you once knew. The results of my test came out today, and as I suspected, it came out positive. I feel like I'm teetering on the edge of reason just thinking about my impending doom. I would give anything not to have to become one of them. As far as I know, you are not infected. I sincerely hope things do not reach such a desperate pass. But if it has turned out that you are now the last person remaining alive, I want you to get the material from the visual data room. Then activate the self-destruct system in the power room and escape from here. Please do everything in your power to make this whole accident public. If everything is still running normally, you should be able to release all the locks using the security system. I've set up the terminal in the small security room so that you can log into the system using my name and your name. Using my name and your name as the password. You will need another password to release the lock of the door in basement level 2 with the visual. As a safety measure, I have coded that password into an x-ray picture. A Rowan. Whatever the fuck that says. I know you and I'm sure you will be able to work it out without any trouble. There's just one more thing. And if it is my last request, I hope you never have to lay eyes on the me. I hope you never have to lay eyes on me in this state. But if you do happen to run into me in my hideous form, I beg you to put me out of my misery. I hope you understand. Thank you, Ada. Yours truly, John. So there you go. There's your hint there, John Ada. So it's John Ada. And you said the other password was cell, wasn't it? So where did you get cell from? There's something scrawled on the notepad. To use the electronic door, place the initials in an alphabetical order. Alright, so we might have to do some jotting down here. So we've got Ed Fisher. This EF. worse. What does this mean then? What does the red mean? So you can go in here now. Right, I'm gonna go and save because I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. Fuck's sake. I didn't put the ink ribbon back. I keep doing that. What? I killed him! I swear I killed him. I swear I put like a whole 100 bullets in that cunt. But he's not dead. And now he don't die, does he? Right, so we've got three fucking ammo discs. What's that purple kid? Well, I'm gonna stop it there, guys. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm stuck. So I'm gonna cut the stream and I'm gonna have a mooch around here and figure out what I've got to do. And we'll be back. Peace.